congratulations. But I wasn't going to let KYA occur and not get to see so many exciting faces from throughout the Commonwealth. I want to thank the Governor and Secretary of State. Look, that was a kind introduction. There will not be a test on that later. Are y'all having fun? That's what it's about. My hope is the work that you are doing over the course of these 3 days, this session, that it doesn't end on Saturday, but yet it continues. You continue to stay involved and be a part of the process, because to me, you are the future of this state. You are why it was worth it for me to put my name on the ballot. You are why I get up every day and go to Frankfort and fight, because unlike what the political pundits want to say, I don't think you are the lost generation. They say in the era of texting and tweeting and chatting, chatting. How many of y'all have your phones? Raise them up. They think that they can't count on you to help get people out to the polls. They think when you're eligible to vote that you won't show up. Do you believe that?
No!
I don't take that bet either. I bet on you. I believe you are the future governor, the future secretary of state, the future treasurer, the future leaders of our House and Senate, our council men and women throughout the Commonwealth of Kentucky. And I'm excited to join you today because it wasn't too long ago that I sat where each and every one of you are sitting as an alum of KYA. Zero in and vote for Allison. Do you think that's a good slogan? I tell you, you've got many more out there that are quite impressive, and I wish all of the candidates that I know are up for election the best of success. I know that they are waging some very inspiring campaigns, and importantly, that each of you are taking the time to get to know them before you cast your vote. Isn't that right? As Secretary of State, I have the privilege to watch over all of the elections that occur in Kentucky, as well as serve as the chief business official, watching over all of the businesses that operate here in the Commonwealth, small and large. And importantly, what brings me to join you here today is the work that I do as Kentucky's chief advocate for civic engagement, getting people to realize that the power their voice and especially their vote has to make a difference at the local, state, and national level. And I will tell each and every one of you here, my time in Frankfort, I was humbled to serve for the past 4 years, and most recently to be reelected as Secretary of State. Some of the best pieces of legislation and ideas that have come to the steps of the Capitol and even made their way into the chambers, they have come from folks just like you. Minds that when people told them to sit down, they stood up. They told them to stop marching, they marched on. They told them they were too young, they said, it's never too early to start making a difference. And that's my hope for each and every one of you. When I first came into office, we did this study called a Civic Health Index to look at the state of where Kentucky's engagement level actually is. Were people a part of organizations? Were they giving of their time? Did they help their friends and their neighbors? Better yet, did they reach into their pockets to make this world, this state, a little bit better of a place? And what we found, while this state was doing great in some great areas, for instance, we were third in the nation in terms of people actually sitting down to frequently eat dinner with their families. My husband will tell you that's not due to my cooking. We were above the national average when it comes to voter registration. But when it came to people actually belonging to groups, the bottom quarter of the nation. Even worse yet, when it came to people giving of the treasures we all have so little of in our pockets. So I set out on a mission to try to see how we could turn the decline that we see in Kentucky's civic health around. We did a tour all across Kentucky's 15 campuses, colleges, and universities, talking with minds, not just elected officials, but students all along the way. You know, we discovered the main theme that brought people together It took intentional acts. It took a direct intention to continue to make a difference. And that's my reason for being here before each and every one of you today. I know the difference that so many KYA alums have made, not just for this state, but for this nation, and I'm counting on you. I need you. The job of Secretary of State is not one that is done on its own. In fact, you are the best microphones anybody could ask for out across the Commonwealth of Kentucky, from Northern Kentucky to Eastern Kentucky, all the way over to Western Kentucky. And I need you to keep the passion, the energy, the excitement that I know you have for the process that you have learned here, and bring it throughout your cities, your counties, but importantly, back to Frankfort. Because you are the future of this state. When I first started out in public service, I'll tell you, it was because of something my mama used to tell me every day before she would send my four sisters and I off to school. Family of five girls, Alyssa, Abby, Allison, Ashley, and Amy. Hey, you is really what I go by. And as she would send my four sisters and I off to school with the breakfast of champions, a Pop-Tart, she would tell my sisters and I this phrase, make this the best day yet. I didn't know then, all those years, what she was meaning. It wasn't until I came out of a courtroom helping a victim of domestic violence that I realized what she was saying. This victim spoke little English. We had to have the aid of an interpreter in the courtroom, but she had a young daughter. We were successful. We made sure she got the protection she needed. She hugged me and a tear came down her face, and it crossed my mind what my mama was saying all those years, make this the best day yet. She was telling me, just as I will share with you, to not be afraid, to take a chance, and most importantly, be the change that you want to see in the world, the change that I know has already happened and will happen when you put your mind to something. I looked around state government at that time, and there weren't too many women. It didn't look like what my dinner table looked like. With Auditor Crit Llewellyn retiring, there was the possibility that there would be no statewide elected female in Frankfort, and as you can imagine, that was unacceptable to me. I grew up helping to get people out to vote on election day, making sure we got people to the polls through rides or calling to make sure that they had the services that they need. And, well, as an attorney, working with businesses throughout the state is something that I was already doing. So you can imagine, when I heard those words in the back of my head, I knew what I had to do, to take a chance, to not be afraid, and most importantly, be that change that I wanted to see in the world. I took that chance and ran my first ever race, a statewide race across the Commonwealth, and folks, we led the ballot then, and we led the ballot this past election. So I'm here to tell you that if I can do it, the youngest female Secretary of State in the nation, each and every one of you can do it. So my hope is that you've not only had a great experience thus far, but you will help to spread the word, because this is the start of what I hope will be a new chapter for each and every one of you to keep Kentucky's kids, and importantly, our communities, engaged. So, how many of y'all are eligible to vote right now? How many of y'all will be 18 come next November? Raise your hand. Now keep that hand up. Keep that hand up if you're eligible to vote. Did you vote this past election? Yes? You did? All right. As y'all know, 31% turnout, that's what we had. Is that acceptable to you?
No.
Do you want people making decisions for you?
No.
You want to be a part of the process, and that is something that I hope you have learned here. You can and do make a difference. I've certified elections, guys, that come down to as little as this past election, 83 votes. That's just that back section back there. Heck, we have Jackson High School here. Do we have Jackson High School here? Yeah, Assumption. Heck, that's Assumption. Assumption. Maybe y'all have 150. That's Assumption High School right there. Make the difference. You all are the future of Kentucky, and importantly, those that are going to be 18 next year, will you register to vote? Let me say yes.
Yes.
Those of you that aren't yet eligible, will you help? tomorrow morning. Is that right, Ben?
Yes.
Tomorrow morning, and I welcome each and every one of you. I know you aren't in the Capitol over the course of these next 3 days, but my door is always open, and as your Secretary of State, it would be my privilege to welcome you all in. Thank you all very, very much.